Storms can wreak chaos, flooding cities and decimating infrastructure. But there's an even bigger worry than wind and rain, that is space weather. If a massive solar storm hit us, our technology would be wiped out. The entire planet could go dark. Solar storm is a generic term used to describe a bunch of stuff the sun hurls our way, including X-rays, charged particles, and magnetized plasma. A massive solar storm hasn't hit the Earth since the 19th century, but space weather scientists are very worried about the possibility of another. A solar storm usually starts with a solar flare. A solar flare is a giant explosion on the surface of the sun that sends energy and particles streaming off into space. We recognize three types of flares. C-class flares are small and they occur all the time and are too weak to affect the Earth. M-class flares are mid-sized and they can produce minor radio disruptions. X-class flares are the largest explosions in the solar system. They can release energy equal to a billion hydrogen bombs. These eruptions occur very rarely, but when they do, they're an epic sight. Despite observing flares for over a century, scientists still aren't totally sure what causes the sun to erupt. We do know that flares have a lot to do with disruptions in the sun's powerful magnetic field, which oscillates over the course of an 11-ish year solar cycle. A mid to large size solar flare would send waves of high energy radiation toward the Earth. These types of radiation are powerful enough to rip electrons off of atoms. Basically, the sky gets zapped with a giant electromagnetic pulse. But even the biggest flares don't impact humans very much. The one exception is radio. Radio signals between the Earth and orbiting satellites can be blocked when the atmosphere becomes too charged. When airplanes are flying over the poles, the only way they communicate with control centers is high-frequency radio waves bouncing over the continents. But it's just a temporary difficulty lasting 10 minutes to hours at the most. We don't have a great way of forecasting solar flares because they hit the Earth too quickly. It takes about 8 minutes for sunlight to reach us. The only thing we can do is issue an alert when we see one. Minutes to hours after a solar flare lights up the sky, a stream of charged particles, electrons and protons, arrive at the Earth. They bombard the magnetosphere, a protective envelope around Earth created by our magnetic field. Occasionally, a large pulse of charged particles will hit orbiting satellites and damage their electronics. Particle radiation is also a big health risk for humans in space. But by and large, the effects of solar particle radiation are buffered by the magnetosphere and atmosphere. It's what's coming next that you and me on the ground need to worry about. When the sun flares up, it sometimes shoots a giant cloud of magnetized plasma off into space. This is called a coronal mass ejection. They are the slowest form of solar weather, taking anywhere from 12 hours to several days to reach the Earth. They're also by far the most dangerous. Fortunately, because they are slow moving, our space weather forecasters have a little more time to anticipate them. A coronal mass ejection will shoot pretty much straight out from the sun, and there's always a good chance that the Earth won't end up in its path. If a coronal mass ejection is coming straight at us, it'll first hit NASA's ACE satellite. If that happens, we've got anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour before a cloud of plasma rains down from above, interacting with our planet's magnetosphere and triggering a geomagnetic storm. Geomagnetic storm strength is measured in disturbance storm time, or DST. This essentially describes how hard a coronal mass ejection shakes up Earth's magnetic field. Ordinary storms, which cause the northern lights to flare up but otherwise don't impact us, register somewhere in the neighborhood of DST equals minus 50 nanoteslas. The worst geomagnetic storm of the space age, which knocked out power across Quebec in March of 1989, registered a DST equals nanotesla. But even that 1989 storm looks puny in comparison to the Carrington event, a geomagnetic storm that zapped the Earth 160 years ago. At the time, the damage wasn't too bad. But a Carrington-sized storm today could spell disaster. The Carrington event of September 1859 is named for Richard Carrington, the English astronomer who saw the sun flare up with his own eyes. In the days following Carrington's observation, a series of powerful coronal mass ejections hit the Earth multiple times. Currents electrified telegraph lines, shocked technicians, set telegraph papers on fire, and caused widespread communications outages. Modern estimates for the strength of this storm range from minus 800 nanoteslas to minus 1750 nanoteslas. Human society is far more reliant on electricity today than it was 160 years ago. Today we have pipelines, electrical transmission grids, and a lot more ground-based electrical conduction technology. So, what would happen if a Carrington-sized event struck us now? Pretty much every aspect of the modern world would take a hit, according to a report by the National Academies of Sciences. The ground currents induced by large geomagnetic storms can melt the copper windings of transformers that lie at the heart of power distribution systems. If this happens, it can lead to massive power outages. And because our power grid has grown much more interconnected over time, the effects of such an outage today could be spread far and wide. It's hard to overstate just how much this would uproot our lives. The lights would of course go out, as would the internet, and any device that draws current from the wall. In places with electronically controlled municipal water supplies, like most modern cities, toilets and sewage treatment systems would stop working. Heating and air conditioning would fail. Perishable food and medication would be lost. ATMs would be useless. Gas pumps would go offline. And so forth. GPS technology would also be knocked out. Some of these effects could last years, and they'd be felt globally. It's important to keep in mind that we aren't talking about some incredibly far-fetched, Armageddon-style apocalypse situation here. In fact, in July of 2012, a massive coronal mass ejection ripped through Earth's orbit and narrowly missed us. That event, which was picked up by NASA Stereo, a satellite, would have registered a DST of minus 1,200 nanoteslas. Thanks to a growing army of space weather observatories, we're much better able to predict coronal mass ejections than we were 20 years ago. Still, most space weather scientists agree that if a massive solar storm struck today, we'd be pretty screwed.